Hi, everybody. I'm DJ Foster, and welcome to the Doug Woods Show, our weekly look at the Grand Valley State softball team with head coach Doug Woods. Coach, thanks for joining me today.
Thank you.
Well, it was an exciting weekend for your team. You only got to play twice, but you went 2-0 against Northwood on Saturday. You had to come from behind in both games. You trailed late, but you came back to win both. You're now 21-4 in the year, 7-1 in the conference play. Talk a little about Saturday's doubleheader.
Well, once again, they put the coach right on the edge there by coming from behind to win, but we'll take it. First game, I think we were behind 5-3, and we scored or 5-4, excuse me, and we scored four in the bottom of the sixth. A lot of people contributed on that, and that sort of set the tone for, you know, the second game too. Everybody jumping in, doing their thing. Becky Gill, we put her in as pinch runner. She has a heck of a slide into home, kicks the ball loose, scores, and then that inning continues with that. Emily Holt came in as a pinch hitter, got a single, scored a run in that. So that was a great effort from everybody in that game. Second game, once again, that one behind 5-3 in our last at bat, and ended up scoring 10 runs with that. And once again, everybody contributing from top to bottom. In fact, in that game, I think we used everybody we had in that game. We had Emily Holt. We had pinch run for her once. We had Carly Rizzutis, our other catcher, bat, came in, pinched hit. So we had to run for Emily Holt again. And who are you going to put in there? Brittany. I said, Brittany, when's the last time you caught? She said high school, but then Emily Jones has caught some for us. So she went and caught the last inning, did a nice job.
Yeah, you were moving people all over the place. It was like
right.
A game of checkers or something. So the first game, you like you said, you won 8-5. You were down 5-4 going into the bottom of the sixth, but you scored four runs. As you said, Emily Holt with the big go-ahead RBI single. And then to open it up a little bit, Katie Martin added a two-run single. Just talk a little bit about the end of that game.
Yeah, you know, with Katie up there, and you know, everybody's thinking, oh, Katie hit a home run. Katie's just a good, solid hitter, and she hit a single and scored two runs for us. And boy, that's what we needed at that time in the game.
Yeah, and then game two, you're down 5-3 in the top of the seventh. The league rules, you switch, so you were the visiting team for that game. The Taylor twins scored scored twice. Both girls scored once to tie the game at 5, and then you just opened the floodgates from there. Kaylee Bertram had a two-run double. Tanya Calkins had an RBI single. Miranda Cleary hit a two-run homer. Breonna Taylor added a two-run double. I mean, you were just going up and down the lineup at 10 runs was what it finished out in the seventh, and you end up winning 13-5.
Well, and I think you're right with Brittany and Breonna. You put them on the base path, they create a little havoc for a team. You know, you can score. Brittany from second base on a ball that just gets to the outfield because of her speed. And her slide in home, there was a bat in front of the plate, and I think she kicked it 20 feet as she came in. She was going as hard as she could at that. And you're right, that sort of sets the tone. It gets the other team thinking a little bit, and then we hit the ball. We really had some consecutive hits and carried us through that inning.
And one thing that might get overlooked so far in the season, he hit a lot of homers, he hit a lot of doubles, but Jackie Toich on Saturday in game two was 5-for-5. She had 5 infield singles, and she's the first Laker since March 4th, 2005, when you coached Tara Marsh, and she went 5-for-5. Talk a little about Jackie's performance. She got on base all 5 times, scored a run.
And she would have had another at-bat, except the coach pinched hit for him. Think back on that, maybe not the greatest move, but... No, she did a nice job, and she was very cerebral about it. The one time she came down and said, what do you think? Do I bunt or do I try to slap here and take a look, see where they're playing? And she did. She dumped a bunt down first base. They couldn't throw her out on that play. So she did a great job. She also made a nice catch going back to the left field fence and took probably a double away from a Northwood batter. So she had a great game, but she's done that all year. She's been pretty consistent at the plate. And the long ball is great, but you need that short ball, that type of stuff. And I think one of hers hits at first. They threw the ball away. We ended up with a run on that. So you create a little havoc for the other team.
Yeah, it's rare just to see anybody get up 5 times in a game, more or less get 5 hits. She had 2 hits in the seventh inning alone. So great job by Jackie. Now, looking forward to this week, you're supposed to play at Hillsdale on Wednesday. Obviously, weather permitting, we learned that this weekend with a couple of rainouts. And then you're supposed to have Lake Superior State in for a weekend set 4 games. Talk a little bit about this week coming up.
Well, yeah. Hopefully, we can get Wednesday's games in at Hillsdale. They are a team in our division since we've gone to divisions this year with softball. Hillsdale's in our division, so we definitely want to get that in. And then we play Lake Superior Saturday and Sunday at home. Record-wise, they've struggled a little bit, but they played two close games with Ferris over the weekend. They lost 5-2 and 4-3. So I know they'll be up for the occasion against us.
Well, we hope the field stay dry for you, and you get a couple games in, and we'll talk to you again next week.
All right, thank you.
And thank you for joining us on the Grand Valley Sports Network. I'm DJ Foster, and we'll talk to you again next week.